Alright, stop. This is a wholesome anime.
Oh, Sayu-chan-so, majide ryori mo iketen jan. Joshi-roku yaba sugi shou.
Now, to start things off with this Japanese-style stew, we're gonna go ahead and peel two large potatoes. I'm using a more dry potato in the russet versus something like a Yukon. The russet potatoes work really, really well for stews because they tend to hold up a lot better because they don't have as much moisture. After peeling your potatoes, make sure you cut them in half and trim away any bad pieces, and then just give these a large dice. This doesn't have to be perfect. You're not trying to go for perfection here. Just make sure that they're a nice large dice, something that will fit on a spoon. Make sure you cut up your potatoes about the same way, throw them into a bowl, and make sure you soak them with water. This is going to help relieve them of some of their starch and keep them from browning. Next thing up is the bell peppers. Don't do it. Don't give me that face. And he's away with the... That's actually pretty good, dude. Not too bad. Okay. After juggling your bell peppers, we're going to give these a slice and remove the stems and the seeds. This is also going to be large diced, similar to how you did the potatoes. Now, don't stop eating all of the prep, dude. It's a pretty good bell pepper, though. I'm gonna be honest. Now, after slicing and removing all of the seeds, go ahead and do those large dice like we were talking about, and you can combine the red and green bell peppers in the same pan. It's not going to make too big of a difference. And once you have all your bell peppers ready to go, move those slightly to the side and grab one large white onion. You can also use a nice sweet onion if you have it, but I like the white onion for a bit of its harshness as well. Now we're going to give this a large dice just like we did for the bell peppers and those potatoes. The reason why you want to keep everything that uniform consistency and size, so that way when you take a big old spoon of stew, you're going to have a bit of everything on that spoon. Now place all the onions on the same sheet tray as the bell peppers, and these are ready to go. What are you doing down there? Did you spill something again? Now onto the beef. I'm using some basic sirloin, but feel free to use whatever cut of beef you want. The sirloin is really nice because it is cheaper, and since we're cooking it for a longer period of time, it tends to hold up well in the stew. Cut your steaks into these nice giant chunks of meat, and with that, most of your mise en place is ready to go.
Now what's great about making this Japanese style stew is you don't actually need too many ingredients, and what's really interesting versus a regular like American style stew is that you add the ingredients at different times versus sometimes you put everything together.
So grab yourself whatever roasting pot you want, jam out to some music while you bring your mirepoix over as slowly as possible, and with just a touch of oil at the bottom of that over a low heat, add in all of your mirepoix while getting completely out of focus for this shot. Now make sure you do stir this up just so that way some of that oil can start coating those vegetables. Now we're gonna season this with just black pepper and no salt because we want this to sweat naturally. After seasoning it, give it another stir and then throw your lid on it. Let this sit here at that low medium heat for around 10 to 15 minutes until those vegetables start to sweat. Remember, we're just trying to sweat the vegetables. We're not trying to cook them or give them too much color. Once the onions are nice and soft and tender, these vegetables are ready to go. Now, I do like to pull out all these vegetables so they don't overcook at all and make sure that they do cool down properly. Yes, bring them over to the... Just place them on the countertop. Don't eat the vegetables. Don't eat the... What do you mean, what am I gonna do about it? Yeah, you got so excited, you almost forgot about the beef, didn't you? Now bring the beef back over to that pot and dump it straight in without removing any of the fond. Once you have your beef in, season this with both black pepper and then hit this with a pinch of salt. After seasoning it, add a cap full of oil, give this another stir, and remember, we're keeping this over that low medium heat because we're not actually trying to brown any of this beef. After about 5 or 6 minutes, you should no longer see any pink on the beef. This is when we're going to add in 1 liter worth of water or beef stock if you have it. I didn't have beef stock on hand, so the water is going to be fine. Now, after adding water, we're adding 100 milliliters of dashi, and we're gonna let this simmer for around 1 hour, just until that beef is nice and tender.
Go play some League of Legends or something, like I'm about to do, because that's productive.
After playing AP Kai'Sa in mid lane, the beef should be done. The best way to test this is just by pulling a piece out and trying it, and if it's tender, you're ready to go. Now, place all of your potatoes directly into that beef. Make sure they're fully submerged, bring this up to a boil, and cook those potatoes. This is also going to evaporate a lot of that liquid, is what you're looking for. If you feel like your potatoes are not done, but the liquid is going away, just add a little more liquid. It's going to be fine. My potatoes are ready to go, so I'm finishing this off with 100 milliliters of sake, followed by 100 milliliters of dark soy sauce, and then 50 milliliters worth of mirin. After you've added your 3 other liquids, give this a quick stir and cook this for an additional 10 to 15 minutes. All we're trying to do now is reduce that liquid by half once again. This is going to start to thicken up from all the starch in the potatoes, and make sure that all the flavors really start coming together. You can tell your stew is ready once you can take a toothpick and just break down one of those potatoes and you can see the layer. You want to make sure that your potatoes aren't colored in the middle. This is how you know they're ready to go.
Plate up time, oh, hot. Also hot. Plate up time.
Now, this is kind of a roundabout method of plating this up, but I'm going to take a couple of spoons of my beef and my potato parts, add in an equal part of vegetables into a bowl, and give this a quick toss. You can also just combine all of it into the Dutch oven, which is probably what I should have done, but I decided I wanted to do it this way just because. Now, once you have everything nicely tossed, place this onto your plate of choice, and this is the only plate that I have been using for the past, like, 6 months, and just try to get as much of that stew on there as possible for that beautiful shot. And there it is, the Japanese beef style style stew from Higehiro, which is still extremely wholesome, and this looks amazing.
There it is, guys, the nikujaga, which I believe means meat and potatoes, or niku and jagaimon, which also means meat and potatoes in Japanese. This thing looks so good and so hearty, and I will admit, I've never made anything like this before. This looks fantastic. So now the real way to do this up with some rice, which I already have, because you should always have rice ready to go. Now we're gonna do a scoop of rice. Yes, one of these guys. You know what, we're gonna go for it, because I didn't think about this plate up. Oh, that's, I cannot tell you how good this smells right now. Look at how tender this is. It just kind of falls apart. The potatoes still taste like potato, but they still have flavor from the sauce. The vegetables still are tender, but still have body to them. This is one of those things you could easily make for everybody, and I highly recommend this one. Check out the recipe at chefpk.com. It's gonna be super easy to put together, and just enjoy it with a bunch of friends. My name is Chef PK. Get subscribed, and remember, keep playing with your food.